Harrison's parents, and 6 months ago they donated her organs, and someone got her heart. They don't know who. So she gets a letter in the mail saying, basically, that the... Wait, did she just show up? No, she wrote a letter. I'm gonna sneeze. Anyway, they get a letter in the mail saying that the person who received the organ, the heart, Madison would like to meet them. And so Julie and Dennis discuss it, and they decide they're gonna go. They meet her at a coffee shop. Her name is Vera. She seems super sweet. She's got a scar on her chest. Pretty much she says, you know, I live every day of my life knowing that I'm only here because your daughter died. Julie breaks down crying, and Vera's like, I'm so sorry, I'm so sorry. Here's my cell if you ever want to get in touch with me. And she leaves. This is a... Is it stippling brush? I think it's called. I've never really used this. So, Julie feels bad about how she reacted, but it was like totally normal. Like, it wouldn't cry, right? So, they get home, and, she pissed at Dennis for. She was mad at Dennis about something. Something he didn't talk to her about. I forget what. Anyway, the next day she's like, come home early, okay? I have a surprise for you. And Vera is in their house, and Dennis is like so upset and uncomfortable with it. He's like, why did you invite her here? So it was like, why would... And she's like, I didn't ask you because I didn't think you'd be okay with it. And it's like, okay, their marriage is crumbling. But so Vera's there. They talk. They have a nice dinner. She asks to use the bathroom, and again, second Lifetime movie recently I've seen. Go ahead, it's upstairs. No, it's not. You live in a... Basically, imagine your bathroom is not upstairs. You have a downstairs bathroom, but whatever. She goes upstairs. They're like, hey, where's Vera? It's been a while. They go looking. She went into their daughter's room and shut the door behind her. Come on. So they go in, and they're like, Dennis is like, what are you doing? Julie's nice about it, you know. Anyway, she ends up saying, oh, I don't know, she's just all this gushy stuff. They end up leaving the room. Vera kind of lags behind and steals a necklace of Madison's. So Julie gets a text from Vera, can you meet up with me? The next day, she's there, and she's like, hey, I stole... Instead of being like, how dare you steal my dead daughter's necklace, she's like, oh my god, you are part of the family. Whack. So, they hug and everything. Pre-COVID, I guess. They hug and everything. Now, Dennis has like a barbecue arranged, and all of his co-workers, or some of his co-workers and friends, are coming. Shows up wasted, drinking straight out of the wine bottle, which suppose... Oh, I forgot to say, when she admitted to stealing and gave back the necklace, she said she told her she's having money problems. So again, without asking her husband, Julie writes a check out to cash for her for $5,000. Are you kidding? So they're having a backyard barbecue. Vera crashes it. They're she wasn't invited, and she's getting wasted, dancing, acting crazy. She shouldn't be drinking with the transplant, right? She's supposedly on all this medication because her body's rejecting it. That's why she needed the $5,000. So agency that somehow like is the liaison between the donor and the person who receives the organ, right? And they're talking and she's like, I can't give you any information. This is where they meet the actual family who received the organ. They go, such a sweet family. It was a young girl, their daughter's age, and they were very grateful and thankful. So they're like, okay, who is Vera? Who is Vera? Why is she doing this? Pretending to have their kid's heart. So, she somehow slipped through like the vetting process. Like, we weren't being as strict because one of our employees died. So then you're like, okay, Riley, Vera murdered the girl in the beginning so she could get a job working there, so she could get these people's information to know where they live. So you're still like, what the heck? Kind of. So they go home and they're looking it up and they figure out seen her since the incident. She went off on a customer and got physical, and she asked me not to tell the boss, but I had to because I couldn't afford to lose the job. So she says all that, gives him some information, first and last name, all that stuff, and the detective leaves, and then Riley's there and kills her. So then she uses that girl's bone. Her name was Sugar. I think they might have worked at her strip club. Sugar texts the detective, I have more information, come to my house. So the detective goes back, goes inside, can't find her anywhere, gets in his car to leave, and Riley's behind him and strangles him. So now she's killed three people. I don't know if this is even relaxing. Plus the noise outside and my dog. I'm sorry, guys. Anyway, it's a Lifetime one, so probably not a lot of people will watch it. So suit, holding a gun. So she has the villain monologue, like, this is your fault, my sister's dead, you don't know what it's like to be a twin, there's a cat and mouse chase through the whole house. She she opens it and she thinks Julie's dead, but she's not. And Julie ends up like spraying her with hairspray. Julie goes to escape, but it locks from the outside for whatever reason. Like, how do you even do that? And then Dennis shows up. I think they hit Riley with something and she's knocked out. They go to get in the car to leave and they go to reverse and she's there with a gun. Oh wait, no. She's there. Starts grabbing Julie through the driver window and attacking her. Julie gets out of the car and she's got, oh no, she was attacking Dennis. Dennis gets out of the car and Julie comes around the side of the car with a gun and shoots Riley, kills her. So that was how it ended, with Riley dead. Riley slash Vera. Oh yeah, what would I give this? This one was weird. I don't know. I guess 6 out of 10. It didn't suck. It wasn't good. It was good enough background noise, I guess. The detective was so dumb. So 6.